Hello, good evening to my professor and to my classmates. This is Nigerian's Castillo, and I'm going to present today the article 1188 to 1192. So before we discuss about Article 1188, let's go back to Article 1187. It was said that there is two retroactive effects in suspensive conditions. So what are there? First is the unilateral obligations. What is unilateral obligation? Unilateral obligations are fruits and interest received shall be appropriated by the debtor. Sa madaling salita, there is only one party who is responsible to comply to the other. But when we say reciprocal obligations, fruits and interest are deemed mutually compensated. When we say mutually compensated, both parties are needed to comply. So now, let's discuss about Article 1188. Article 1188 is something to do with the rights of the creditor and debtor in a conditional obligation. The creditor may, before the fulfillment of the condition, bring the appropriate actions for the preservation of his right. The debtor may recover what during the same time he has paid by mistake in case of a suspensive condition. So to understand fully the Article 1188, let's have a simple example. So Roward promised Jill a specific kitten on her birthday. On this case, Jill's birthday is not yet done. Kumbaga, her birthday is going to happen pa lang. Hindi pa siya nangyayari. But then, si Roward nag-promise siya ng specific na kitten. But then, the situation is, hindi pinapakain ni Roward yung kitten, so malapit na siyang mamatay. So in this case ulit, Jill has the right to bring a preservation in a specific action against doon sa kitten. Although, hindi pa yun sa kanya or hindi pa kay Jill yung specific kitten, meron pa rin siyang right. Doon, right pa rin yung debtor, which is si Roward, na pakainin at alagaan yung kitten. May right si Roward na gawin yun para ma-preserve or para maingatan niya yung kitten at umabot pa sa birthday ni Jill. Diba, when we say an obligation to give a determinate thing, hindi siya pwedeng palitan ng kahit na anong bagay. Lalo na kung si Jill, gusto niya talaga yung specific cat or kitten na yun. Pwede siyang gumawa ng preservation against that action until her birthday. Kasi from that time, doon na talaga niya makukuha yung specific kitten para sa araw na yon physically. So let's have a next example. Jill has a 60,000 debt to Roward payable after 3 years. 1 year before maturity, having thought that 3 years already elapsed, pay Roward the 60,000 debt. So ang nangyari dito, akala niya nag-due na or nag-mature na yung utang. Kailangan na niyang bayaran. So, ito namang si Jill, nung binayaran siya, hindi siya umimik. I'm sorry, ito pa lang si Roward. Nung nagbayad si Jill sa kanya, hindi siya umimik na hindi pa naman pala nag-due. Wala siyang sinabi, even a simple word na, wala ba namang 3 years ha, bakit nagbayad ka na? The only thing that he do is, tinanggap niya lang yung pera. In this case, we can say that it is a principle of solution debity, wherein nabayaran niya to through mistakes. So meron ditong obligation si Roward na ibalik niya muna yung pera kay Jel because it is not yet due. Hindi pa rin natatapos yung parang hindi pa natatapos yung taon na agreement nila kung kailan siya pagbabayad talaga. At from the time na hindi pa niya nababalik yung pera, syempre merong possibility na mag-accrue na interest doon. After 1 year, nagbayad siya and 6 months, pagkatapos ng 6 months ulit, nagkaroon ng lapses. Tapos doon pa lang naalala ni Jel na, uy Roward, nabayaran na pala kita hindi pa naman due. Pwede mo bang ipalik muna sa akin kasi hindi pa yun naglalapse ng 3 years? On behalf of those exact amount, which is the 60,000, kinakailangan ni Roward na dagdaga ng interest yung pera kung hanggang kailan niya nakuha. For example, dumating yung pera noong 6 months ago pa pero hindi pa nagjuju. 6 months din yung interest na kailangan niyang idagdag. It's the number one rule in there. So next, puntahan natin ang conditional obligations, loss, deterioration, and improvement of a thing during dependency of the condition. It answers what are the rules. The rules is under Article 1188. So when the conditions have been imposed with the intention of suspending the efficacy of an obligation to give, the following rules shall be observed in case of improvement, loss, or deterioration of the thing during dependency of the condition. So number one, if the thing is lost without the fault of the debtor, the obligation shall be extinguished. So there is a specific word that says that loss without fault of the debtor. So this incident might be fictitious. So next, if the thing is lost through the fault of the debtor, he shall be obliged to pay damages. It is understood that the thing is lost when it perishes or goes out of commerce or disappears in such a way that its existence is unknown or it cannot be recovered. Number three, when the thing deteriorates without the fault of the debtor, the impairment is to be borne by the creditor.
Therefore,
it clearly said in there that the debtor has no fault if it deteriorates. Next is number four, if it deteriorates through the fault of the debtor, the creditor may choose between the rescission of the obligation and its fulfillment with indemnity for damages in either case. So the number 5 and 6 only refers to improvement. Number 5, if the thing is improved by its nature or by time, the improvement shall inure to the benefit of the creditor. So number 6, if it is improved at the expense of the debtor naman, he shall have no other right than that granted to the usufructuary. So, yung ibig sabihin naman ng number 6, kahit gastusan mo yung bagay na yon, wala siyang ibang pwedeng mapares doon. Pwede mo lang gawin ay it's either ilagay mo lang yung mga improvements na nandoon or tanggalin mo. But then, you cannot remove that improvement kung magkakaroon siya ng damages doon sa principle na tinatawag. So, here is our summary. So, loss, deterioration, and improvement. So, yung number 2 po, sobrang importante niyan doon sa part ng improvement, yung last part, which is that he can offset any improvement, the damages he may pay by reason of deterioration of the thing through his fault. What if nag-improve? So, meron din siyang chance na mag-deteriorate. Diba po, pag sinabi natin ito ay na-deteriorate through a debtor's fault or action. So, of course, he will pay some damages and or in case of through debtor's fault action, magkakaroon po siya ng payment through damages or rescission. But then, dun po sa babayaran niyang damages, pwede niyang i-minus or tanggalin yung mga improvement na nailagay niya. Para medyo mamitigate naman po yung damages na babayaran niya. So for Article 1190, when the conditions have for their purpose the extinguishment of an obligation to give, the parties upon the fulfillment of said condition shall return to each other what they have received. In case of the loss, deterioration, or improvement of the thing, the provisions which, with respect to the debtor, are laid down in the preceding article shall be applied to the party who is bound to return. As for obligations to do and not to do, the provisions of the second paragraph of Article 1187 shall be observed as regards the effect of the extinguishment of the obligation. Next is the Article 1191. The power to rescind obligation is implied in reciprocal ones. In case one of the obligor should not comply with what is incumbent upon him, the injured party may choose between the fulfillment and the rescission of the obligation with the payment of damages in either case. He may also seek rescission event after he has chosen fulfillment. If the latter should become impossible, the court shall decree the rescission claim unless there be just case authorizing the fixing of a period. This is understood to be without prejudice to the rights of third persons who have acquired the thing in accordance with Article 1385 and 1383-88 in the mortgage law. So let's have an example. First is example number one, Charles sold to Rachel his flat screen TV. There was no stipulation regarding delivery of the TV and payment of the price. So diba, before I begin, I have discussed about reciprocal obligation. When we say reciprocal again, both parties have obligation to one another. They both need to comply. And kung papansinin natin yung example, walang binanggit na terms with regards of the payment and with regards of the price. Kaya nga nakalagay dito, there was no stipulation. So sa madaling salita, walang time and walang period of obligation sa pinag-usapan ng bawat isa. So ang rule kapag reciprocal, from the time na kailangan niyang gawin yung obligation, ayun na rin yung time na kailangan na rin gawin ng isa. So, in this time, kapag nagbayad na si Rachel ng payment niya doon sa TV, Charles has the obligation to deliver agad yung flat screen TV. Vice versa lang, kapag binayaran yung TV, kailangan i-deliver agad. That's it. So, sinabi naman natin non-reciprocal obligation, meron siyang time, period of time na kailangan bayaran. But it not necessarily mean na kailangan siya bilateral. Kaya kapag bilateral, meron siyang obligation sa bawat isa. Kung bilateral natin dito, pwede siyang mahati ng non-reciprocal at reciprocal. Although parehas sila ng bilateral, parehas silang parts ng bilateral, hindi parehas ng effects. In the last part of my report, which is the Article 1192, it discussed that in case both parties have committed a breach of the obligation, the liability of the first infractor shall be equitably tempered by the courts. If it cannot be determined which of the parties first violated the contract, the same shall be deemed extinguished and it shall be bear with his own damages. Since I don't have any example in this article, magbibigay na lang po ako ng dalawang scenario or isang scenario about sales. So there are two parties in there, which is the seller and the buyer. Both parties na ito ay posible siyang magloko. But then, but But then, pag ang seller ang unang nagloko, meron siyang babayaran na damages under the contract of sale. But then, nagloko rin dito sa scenario na to ang buyer. Ang mangyayari dito, ang magpipay ng damages is the seller kasi siya yung naunang magloko. There must be situation na masasabi nating nagloko lang yung buyer kasi nagloko rin yung seller. So, paano naman natin madedetermine kung hindi natin alam kung sino sa seller or buyer ang nagloko? Hindi nga po, sa Article 1192, the same shall be deemed extinguished and it shall be bear his own damages. So, that was the end of my presentation. I hope you all understand and thank you so much for listening. Have a good day.